The Muse S Athena is a brainwave reading headband that claims to improve focus, mental stamina, and sleep by being the first and only device to combine EEG and fNIRS technology all from the comfort of home. But what new features come with the latest model? Do they actually work? And is it worth the money? Let's find out. So this is actually the third of Muse's products that I've shown on this channel. I started with the Muse 2, then I did the Muse S, and now I'm doing a Muse S Athena review. And this brand new Muse S Athena has completely replaced the previous Muse S. You can't even get that one anymore. Fortunately, at least on paper, it looks like Muse S Athena is a straight upgrade in most ways, as it can do everything the older models can do and more. Just taking a look at it straight out of the box, I immediately noticed some big improvements to the hardware. Visually, I think it's got a much sleeker and more aesthetic color scheme. They've updated the EEG sensors for better connection strength and durability. And I'm really glad to see they switched over to using a USB-C charging port rather than the old micro USB. But the biggest new addition to the Muse S Athena are the fNIRS sensors, which allow Muse to read your brain's blood flow and oxygenation levels. And we'll dive into all the fNIRS stuff later in the video. Whether you like Muse or not, I think the Muse S Athena is pretty objectively a straight upgrade from the previous Muse S and Muse 2 models. It's higher quality, it's more modernized, and it packs more features than anything before it. But with that said, it's also a good deal more expensive than the Muse 2. So we definitely want to make sure all these premium features work as intended and determine whether or not they're worth the added cost to you. By the way, if you do decide to buy either of the currently available Muse headbands, I'll drop some links down below that'll keep updated with the current best deals possible, and using these links will also help support the channel, which I greatly appreciate. Let's start by taking a look at the core features present in both the Muse 2 and the Muse S Athena. Both Muse headbands include a gyroscope, accelerometer, EEG sensors, and PPG sensors. This lets them measure movement, posture, breathing patterns, heart rate, and brain activity. The Muse S Athena can do a bit more with sleep cycle tracking and now fNIRS sensors that track blood flow and oxygenation in your brain. Muse has done a pretty damn impressive job of cramming so many different medical grade sensors into one small, consumer-friendly home device. I mean, as someone with shitty self-employed health insurance in the US, I'm sure that getting any one of these measurements done at a doctor's office would be a lot more expensive for me. Now, the biggest reason to buy Muse, in my opinion, is still the EEG sensors. That hasn't changed. This is Muse's original selling point as a brand, and I do think they do meditation guidance and tracking better than anyone. The EEG sensors on either headband can read your brainwaves in real time and give you immediate biofeedback according to your focus levels. So, for example, if you wanted to get better at meditating, it can play ambient sounds like rain, which intensify when your thoughts are scattered, but quiet down and give way to chirping birds when your mind is calm and meditating successfully. It's kind of like having a guide that keeps you on track when your mind starts to wander. After your meditation session, Muse will give you a progress report where it tells you how focused or distracted you were, how still or fidgety you were, and how your heart rate was throughout the session. Muse has a lot of different programs to choose from to help you with all kinds of cognitive goals, but I've already got videos where I go deep into those, so for now, I'll just say that the data is definitely legit and accurate. I've got ADHD and I'm not the most disciplined meditator in the world, so a lot of times I can feel my focus slipping during sessions, and then I can see it clearly reflected in my progress report, like down to the second accurate. But the Muse S Athena can do everything we just discussed and more since it's got some extra sensors now. First off, because of the way it's designed with this stretchy, comfortable headband, the Muse S Athena can be worn throughout the night to give highly accurate sleep stage information. I've compared my data on this to other popular activity and sleep trackers, and it's definitely accurate. There's also a feature called the digital sleeping pill, which is designed to help you fall asleep and stay asleep throughout the night. And this will basically run a program that will quiet down or pause when it notices you've fallen asleep, and then start back up and guide you back to sleep if it sees that you've woken up in the middle of the night. To be 100% honest, I don't like sleeping with things on my body and I don't have issues sleeping, so I don't really use this feature much personally, but a lot of people who do have issues with sleep say that they love this. Then we get to the newest feature addition and the biggest reason people are upgrading to the Muse S Athena, and that's the fNIRS sensors. Previously, if you wanted to measure blood flow or blood oxygenation in your brain, you'd need to purchase a totally separate product for this, but apparently Muse is the first EEG product to combine fNIRS with their product, with EEG. But just having these fNIRS sensors means that Muse is able to gather a lot more data, which it can use in conjunction with the data from all the other sensors we discussed to provide deeper personal insights. The first new program they've added that uses fNIRS technology is a game called MindFlight, where you try to make an owl fly as far as you can just by focusing your mind. And this is meant to train your mental strength and endurance by coming back to it and practicing over time. I think it's pretty cool, and it's definitely humbling when your focus slips and you can see that little owl just plop down on the ground. And sometimes I absolutely just can't get it to go, and I think that's my ADHD at work. You can also view a visual representation of your brain's blood flow and oxygenation in real time, which opens the door to a lot of testing to see how things like caffeine, breath work, or cold showers might affect those levels. And a lot of people don't know this, but there are actually a handful of really high quality third-party apps that will work with Muse's hardware to give you even more brain training programs, data, and insights, unlocking a whole new level of value for biohackers and data nerds. Muse does have an optional subscription that unlocks some additional features like Alpha Peak, which is basically like the HRV of your brain, a sort of numeric value to represent your brain's overall performance level. But you can decide for yourself whether or not that's worth the additional cost, because honestly, they already do more than enough without the premium membership fees. So both Muse headbands are legit and work great, but which one should you buy? Let's figure it out. And no matter which one you get, I'll drop some links down below that I'll keep updated with the best current deals possible, and using those links will also help support the channel, which I greatly appreciate. So the biggest thing to consider when choosing a model is the new sensors and features of the Muse S Athena. If the fNIRS sensors, tracking blood flow and oxygenation in your brain, and sleep stage tracking sound valuable to you, it could be worth spending the extra money. Also, since the Muse S Athena is a brand new product, it's a bit more future-proof and will last longer than the Muse 2 before being outdated. But if you're solely interested in the EEG data and the meditations, the Muse 2 might be enough for you. Personally, I have a pretty strong preference for the Muse S Athena over the Muse 2, and this is mostly because I just find the Muse S Athena a lot more comfortable and less distracting to wear than the Muse 2, which makes me a lot more likely to actually use it consistently. I also let a friend of mine use my Muse 2, and weirdly enough, we just couldn't really get it to work with her head shape. But the Muse S headband eliminates that problem entirely. Also, I really hate having to dig the micro USB charger out of my junk drawer, so I prefer the Muse S Athena's USB-C port by far. But if you're still on the fence, you could check out this video for a deeper dive into Muse's app and to figure out which brain training features are most important to you. Yeah, give it a watch. Give it a watch. Yeah.